Hello, hello, my beautiful students. How are you today? I hope that you are pretty, pretty fine. Hola, hola, mis preciosos alumnos, ¿cómo están? Espero de lo mejor. Okay, let's start with this that I have here for you that is going to be pretty, pretty useful because we are going to be talking about different and certain things. Vamos a estar hablando de diferentes cuestioncitas, okay? But for that reason, let me show to you my presentation. Déjenme entonces le muestro mi presentación. As we are finishing this week, I need to be very, very clear with this that I have here for you. Tengo que ser muy clara con esto que tengo para ti. Okay, for that reason, I'm going to be mixing English and Spanish a little bit. Okay, only for this last week that we are having this. Okay, here we go. First of all, I would like to say I love this meme. Amo este meme. For that reason, we are finishing with this. Okay, estamos terminando con ello. Hey there and hello there. It's a pleasure to have you here. For that reason, let me tell you one more time. Welcome. Qué gusto tenerte aquí. Por eso déjame decirte welcome. And let's continue learning something new every day. Vámonos con algo nuevo cada día. Okay, chan. What are we going to do? ¿Qué vamos a hacer? What are we going to do? We are going to start with this that I have here. Ooh, here we go. We are going to be having a roulette, but with past tenses. And I'm going to be asking you some questions. Voy a hacer unas preguntitas que me tienes que responder. In 30 seconds, let me use this one. Okay, what time did you go to bed yesterday? 30 seconds. What time did you go to bed yesterday? 30 segundos. What time did you go to bed yesterday? Ready? Stop! I cannot help you with the translation because it's a pause that we are going to be working with this. No te puedo ayudar con la traducción porque con eso es con lo que vamos a estar trabajando. We can. Number two, how old were you when you started to study English? How old were you when you started to study English? 30 seconds. Ready? Okay, that's cool. I got another question. Todo esto es pasado, estamos repasando pasado. We are reviewing past, ¿sale? ¿Por qué estamos traduciendo? Porque tenemos compañeritos nuevos en el nivel que se gradúan con nosotros esta semanita. Entonces, hay que apoyarlos tantito. English, Spanish, right? For that reason, we are here. What time did you get up last Sunday? Pero ya el siguiente nivel ya nos vamos así con todo. Now we are going to be helping you. Les va a estar ayudando. What time did you get up last Sunday? What time did you get up last Sunday? Okay, stop. What? I'm going to be helping you with these questions, okay? And with my answers. Te ayudo hasta con mis propias respuestas. What did you have for dinner yesterday? Tell me. What did you have for dinner yesterday? ¿Qué cenaste ayer? Stop. In my case, I had for dinner a milkshake. And the last one, where did you go last summer? Where did you go last summer? Where did you go last summer? Ready? Stop. In my case, the last summer, I went during the last summer, I went to Puebla, I believe. I don't remember. Another. What was the name of your first English teacher? What was the name of your first English teacher? In my case, no, I don't remember the name of my first English teacher. She was bad and rude with me. Boo. Maybe for that reason, I don't remember her name. Excellent. Number 7. Who were you last Christmas lunch with? Who were you last Christmas lunch with? What is that? What is that? Stop. In my case, I was with my family. Excellent. We were answering different questions in past. Let me tell you something. That was super cool. Estuviste respondiendo preguntas en pasado. This is super cool because it is going to be helping you to have like a general review of verbs, of tenses, grammatical structures, and so on. Te sirve muchísimo para repaso de gramática, vocabulario, tiempos, etc. But in this moment, let's practice reading. Oh, are we going to be practicing reading? Yes, and that is going to be super easy, okay? We are going to be doing this exercise a zoo day, but we are going to be doing it together. Sale, vamos a empezar porque lo vamos a hacer en nuestra clase presencial. The first one. Can you give me a name of a large city? Te doy coche que lo busques. The name of a large city. Excellent. Could you tell me about someone in your family? A name of someone in your family. Okay, can you tell me an animal? Can you give me the name of another animal? Okay, can you give me a word that tells the size of something? Can you give me two colors? Ay, are you ready? Can you give me a food? Okay, girls and boys. Here we're starting with something that is super easy. No te lo voy a traducir, tú puedes. Let's do this. Let's work with the first exercise. And this is going to be the homework that we are going to have in order to work together. Con esta parte de abajo vamos a trabajar juntos, okay? What is this? With this, we are going to be practicing reading and writing, the sequence of the ideas and so on. Vamos a estar practicando secuencias de ideas, entre otros, okay? This is homework. You can check it out, but during the class, we are going to be working with that, okay? This is what we need to investigate and we need to do, depending of what you think, depending de lo que piensas. Okay, now with this, indeed, we are going to be working in this moment. It is important that you can be practicing your reading and writing. Vamos a trabajar con este. Es importante que practicamos nuestra lectura y escritura. It is a silly outfit. What are we going to be doing? We are going to be filling in the blanks with the type of word described. Okay, we are going to be working with that. We are going to be filling in the blanks with the type of word described. Con la palabra descrita, con esa vamos a trabajar. For example, school subject, color, thing, describing word, color, and thing. What could it be? What could it be? 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute. Ready? Okay. In my case, in what is a school subject? In English. In English class, yesterday, our teacher was wearing a color. Red, what? Una cosa, a red, I don't know, shirt. He was wearing a red shirt. She looked pretty, porque es una pretty, es una palabra para describir. She looked pretty. I want a blue jacket, it could be, to wear. These kind of exercises are super cool and super good because they help you with reading and writing and following some patterns and so on. This is my example. This is my example. Let me know about your example. Okay. Well, let's continue with this that I have here for you. This is going to be another extra activity that we are going to be working with together, okay? But I do really recommend that if you have the opportunity to be practicing your writing also every single day, well, that could be great, okay? This is the case of a missing what? What is missing in your house? The missing table, okay. And with this info, we are going to be trying to complete everything that we are having here. Okay, con esta información vamos a ir intentando completar el texto, but little by little, because during our class, we are going to be working with this. Okay, pero empieza a leer de qué se trata este borrador, qué onda, qué es. Well, you are going to be having an extra page for reading. Let me know if it is so difficult for you or if it is super easy with different exercises and examples. Well, let's start with this that I have here for you. Yesterday, we were talking about the prepositions, right? Do you remember about the prepositions? So because we are going to start with that, let me show you this video that is going to be interesting, a kind of little interesting for you, super fast, don't worry, in order to review some prepositions.
Prepositions of place.
Okay.
In.
In.
At.
On.
On.
In.
In. Enclosed spaces.
Closed spaces.
In the square.
In the square. Lugares cerrados.
At. Specific locations.
Specific locations.
At the corner.
At the corner. Specific places, lugares específicos, surfaces, superficies.
On the square.
On the square. Sobre
examples.
El.
Lewis.
Lewis.
Is in the lift.
Lewis is in the lift.
Lewis is now at the lift.
At the lift. Not in, at.
Peter is at the table.
At the table.
Jenny is on.
On
the table.
The table.
Brian is in jail.
In jail. Dentro de.
The flag is on the White House.
The flag is on the White House.
The president is in the White House.
In the White House. Okay. We were talking about these three prepositions of place that are going to be very useful for us. Really, these three prepositions are going to be the main prepositions that we are going to be using today. Estas tres preposiciones son de las que más vamos a estar utilizando el día de hoy. Okay, they are going to be super duper easy, super duper easy. But yes, I'm going to be taking my time, okay? Let me tell you that they are going to be different kind of prepositions. Vamos a tener muchas preposiciones. Acuérdate que una preposición nos muestra diversas cuestiones. Pueden ser de tiempo, de lugar, entre otros. But today we are going to start with this that I have here for you. Primero, vámonos con las fáciles that we were having, okay? Yesterday. Vamos calentando de a poquito. We can do it. Where is the rabbit? Tell me. It's on the hat, it's in the hat, or it's on the table. You can do it. I'm crying because of the prepositions. It's in the hat. It is in. In the hat, it is in the hat. Okay, hi. What's going on here? My presentation. Remember, in the hat. Excellent. Right, let me share again my presentation here. Déjame presentar. A ver, nada más se me fue hasta abajo de mis 500 diapositivas. It is in that. Okay. Now, where it is in the hat. Okay, bye. Thank you. Next, where is the dog? Where is the dog? It's on the book, it's in the car, or it's in the box. It's on the box, it's in the car, or in the box. It's in the car, it's in the car. Okay, that's good. Now, where is the cat? It's in the bag, on the bag, on the table. What could it be? It's in the bag, in. We are talking about this. Vamos desmenuzando esto. Vamos poco a poco. Vamos desmenuzando esto. Okay, now, where are the fish? Where are the fish? The fish are on the desk. The fish are in the water. Or the fish are on the tree. The fish are in the water. Remember that fish could be singular or plural, and fishes is going to be for plural, but with different kind of fishes, different species, okay? Where is the turtle? Where is the turtle? It's on the fish, it's in the fish, it's on the turtle. It's on the turtle. Excellent, excellent. Where is the bird? Where is the bird? It's in the tree, on the house, in the house. On the house, that's great. Where is the frog? It's on the desk, it's in the box, or it's on the book. It's on the book. Excellent. Those are some prepositions. Finally, where is the mouse? It's on the box, book, it's on the table, or it's in the classroom. It's in the classroom. Very well. Excellent. So that was the reason why we were doing that exercise. Uy, ¿por qué estuvimos haciendo ese ejercicio? Perfecto, para empezar calentando motores with these prepositions that we are going to be having. There are going to be different prepositions of place. We were starting with some. We are going to continue with other prepositions, okay, that we are going to be having, porque son bastantes. En serio, entonces en cada nivel vamos viendo diversas preposiciones, preposiciones y preposiciones. For that reason, let's start with these that are going to be helping us in different stages here with us. We are going to be having in, on, at. ¿Por qué crees que al principio vimos el in, on, at? ¿Por qué crees que desde ayer te estoy dando lata con las preposiciones? Because we are going to start, look at this. This is going to be from general to specific, okay? Here we start from general to specific situation. In, on, at. In, on, at. We are going to be making use of in with neighborhoods. For example, I am in Chinatown. With cities, I am in Washington. With countries, we are in the United States. Or places with tap and dairy. Mira nada más, por eso es que te digo que me quiero tomar mi tiempo porque es de los temas más específicos que vamos a estar teniendo para tu cambio de nivel. No, porque luego dices, pero sí, ya lo vi. O ya lo debí de haber visto, ya lo debiste haber visto. Exacto. Pero luego hay confusión, sí, ya. Ok. We are going to be having in. In, on, at. Y empezamos de la general específico. El in con barrios, con ciudades, países, con lugares que tengan fronteras, ¿ok? Places with tap and dairy. Cualquier lugar que tenga cierta frontera, te vas a estar utilizando el in. With on, we are going to be using on streets, avenues, for example, on the Pennsylvania Avenue, with islands, and with large vehicles, okay, vehicles. Con calles y avenidas, islas y vehículos largos. Train, bus, and ship, okay. On is going to be for this one, streets, avenues, islands, and large vehicles, okay. In few words, with all the surfaces, con todas las superficies, we are going to be making use of on. Sale, aquí es donde entra el on. And then we are going to be having at. At, yes. With at is going to be for addresses, my addresses, para direcciones. I don't know, 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue for specific locations or for specific points. El at lo vas a utilizar con direcciones y con locación o lugares específicos. I am at home, estoy en casa. I am at the corner, estoy en la esquina. No estás diciendo ni que estás arriba, ni que estás sobre, sino que ahí estás. In viewers, okay? And this is what we are going to be having. In, remember that in is going to be inside something, something with boundaries. In, pero en como adentro, en adentro, pero en cosas que tengan ciertas fronteras, ciertos límites, ¿sale? On, remember that on is going to be for the surfaces. Todo lo que quieras poner, pero en las superficies, ¿ok? And also, if you're going to be talking about the streets, avenues, islands, and large vehicles. And at is going to be a specific place. No, no estamos hablando de general, de que ahí anda. No, specific. The ball is at the box. La pelota está en la caja, pero no te estoy diciendo si adentro o sobre, sino que ninguna de esas dos. Ahí está de manera específica. At the corner, en la esquina, por ejemplo. These are going to be the prepositions of place. Estamos hablando de preposiciones ahorita, de lugar, no de tiempo, okay? And the prepositions of place are going to be used to show the position or the location of one thing in the relation to another. Estas preposiciones nos sirven para mostrar la posición o la localización de una cosa con relación a otra, ¿no? ¿Dónde está una cosa y la otra? And what we were saying, on, in, at, under. Under, you know what is under. Under a tree, under a table, under the chair, under your bed, under a bridge. Well, this is easy. Debajo del árbol, debajo de la mesa, debajo de la silla, debajo de tu cama, bajo tu el puente. The situation is going to be here with this. Por eso te digo, tranquilo, que ayer te fue bien con todas las preposiciones facilukis, bonitas, hermositas. But now we are going to start with this. No, es que son, no, son muchas, pero las que te van a dar latita son el on, in, at. A little bit, a little bit. On, remember, on a bus, it is going to be a large transport. On the way, on the left, on the right, on a ship. Okay. In a car, in a taxi, in Park Street, in the middle, in a row, in the sky. Wow. And for example, at, remember that at is going to be more specific and in a specific place. Okay, in a row, en una fila, ¿no? At reception, at the side, at the bottom, at the top, at college. En el colegio, en la parte de arriba, en el lado, en la recepción. But we are not mentioning if I am in or on. No, it is going to be general. Okay, that is the situation. Let's see, in, on, at. Ya se empieza a poner, bueno, antes de irnos a comparar entre lo que son los de tiempo y empezar a ver dónde están esos, we are going to be having these that I have here, okay? This is going to be super easy. No te me estreses. No te me preocupes. Al principio es como, oh my goodness. Am I going to be understanding this? Yes, indeed. Sometimes it's like, híjole, no, está muy difícil. No le voy a captar. Nah, sí. We are going to be practicing and practicing and practicing. Don't worry. In, on, at. Mira nada más lo que te vamos a poner aquí. Super, super easy. Lo más fácil, ¿sale? For that reason, here we go. Déjame que pase este anuncio. ¡Ah! We want la lechera. No, les prometo que no me pagan por promocionarla. Here we go. I'm not promoting also this one. Promise. Ah, okay. Qué vergüenza, qué vergüenza. Okay, here we go.
In today's lesson, we are going to learn about prepositions of place and the three basic ones, which are in, on, and at. Here you can see a dog on a box. Now you can see the dog in a jeep. And now the dog is at the store. So how do we use them? Well, for in, we use it when we are talking about inside something. On, when we're talking about just above something but touching it. And at, when we want to show an exact place.
Mira, in, inside something, en, pero dentro de algo. On, just above something, justo sobre algo, pero tocándolo. At, it is going to be talking or showing an exact point.
Or point. So here we have a dog inside a big city.
Inside.
So we would say the dog is in New York. In this one, the dog is at an exact place. So we would say the dog is at the cinema. In this one, the dog is above something but touching it. So we would say the dog is on the island. Okay, let's talk about where I am and where my things are. I am at school. I am in the classroom. My globe is on the table and my books are on the table.
Can you see the difference between I am at school? Estoy en la escuela, un lugar en específico, no te estoy diciendo, estoy en adentro de la escuela. I am at the school. I'm at the market. I am at the mall. Estoy en el mall, en la plaza. Estoy en el mercado. Estoy en la escuela. I am at the school. Pero aquí, I am in the classroom. Aquí ya estás especificando que estás en el salón, pero en ahí adentro específicamente. No, no sé. Haz de cuenta que va por niveles. Sí, estoy aquí. Por ejemplo, ahorita estoy en mi casa, que es tu casa. Estoy en mi casa. I am at my house. Pero te voy a decir, I am in my studio. ¿Ves la diferencia? I am at my house. I am in my studio. Estoy en mi casa. I am in the studio. Estoy en el estudio aquí, metida aquí adentro, ¿no? My glove is on the table. Touching the table. My books are on the table too. También están ahí.
Now, time to test your understanding.
Vamos a ver qué tal nos ve.
School challenge.
What could it be? Where is the cat? The cat is on the chair, at the chair, or in the chair? On the chair. Where is the cat? The cat is in the table, at the table, on the table. On the table, tocando una superficie especial. Where is the cat? In the art room, at the art room, on the art room. In the art room. In, específicamente dentro de ese salón. Where is the cat? It is in here. The cat is at New York, in New York, on New York. In New York, en Nueva York. Where is the cat? It's at work, in work, on, it's on work. It's at work. En el trabajo en Nueva York. En general, está en el trabajo. Ok, un lugar en específico. New York. Oh, the cat is in New York. El gato está en Nueva York, pero ándale, en esa ciudad. No es específico, pero ¿en qué parte en específico? ¿En Brooklyn? ¿Debajo del puente? ¿En los suburbios? Where? The cat is at the work. Está en el trabajo. Muy específico, está en el trabajo, está en la iglesia, in something like that. Aquí es donde empezamos. A ver, está entre el in y el at. What do you think? Kind of easy or difficult? Let me show you that I have here for you. Okay. Now that we were talking about this, Mansión del Inglés, te recomiendo mucho esta página. We are going to be having this. Pero quiero recordarte, we are going to be having some preposition of times or preposition of place, preposiciones de tiempo y de lugar. Ahorita estamos, te voy a mostrar más o menos de ambas. Y en cuanto las vayamos usando poco a poquito, te voy a ir diciendo de tiempo, de lugar. Mira, at, in, on, significan en o a. At is going to be, cuando estamos hablando de preposiciones de lugar, o sea, ¿dónde está algo? Se va a referir a la posición en un punto lugar concreto. Por ejemplo, he works at the bank. Él trabaja en el banco. ¿Sale? Si lo utilizas como de tiempo, lo vas a estar usando para horas o momentos específicos. Aquí con el at, todo es específico. He was there at 7 o'clock. He was there at 7 o'clock. Now, we are going to be having this other that we are going to have in. Si va a ser para del lugar, se va a referir a la posición dentro de un entorno tridimensional, es decir, algo que tiene fronteras, algo donde tú estás inmerso adentro. con fronteras, con márgenes, con pared. Y para de tiempo se va a emplear para meses, años o estaciones. Con los meses, años o estaciones, tú vas a estar utilizando el in, ¿sale? Lugares, con dentro de una cuestión con tus tres dimensiones, ¿no? Altura, espacio, etcétera. Un edificio, un bosque, una plaza, el mercado, una casa, ¿sale? O si los utilizas como de lugar, va a estar hablando de la posición, pero sobre una superficie. Está en, pero sobre una superficie. Si lo utilizas como de tiempo, va a estarse empleando para fechas, días de la semana, entre otros. ¡Cuidado! Cuando veamos ahorita el in y el on de tiempo, las vamos a regresar a esto. My computer is on the table. Mi computadora está sobre la mesa o en la mesa. ¿Sale? We will see you on Sunday. Te vemos el domingo. ¿Sale? We are going to be having this. Bueno, aquí aguas entre el at y el in. El in, como te decía, algo, la posición dentro de un entorno tridimensional, es decir, que tú estés dentro de algo que tiene anchura, altura y profundidad, es decir, ancho, alto y profundo. Un edificio es alto, ancho y profundo. El bosque es alto, ancho y profundo. ¿Sale? Aquí es uno de los tips para que reconozcamos cuando es el at. ¿Sale? At the work, en el trabajo. No, bueno, no te estoy diciendo en la oficina. Una cosa es el trabajo específico. No puedes decir, mi trabajo tiene anchura, altura y profundidad. No. La oficina tiene altura, anchura y profundidad como cuestiones de lugar, ¿sale? Mira, at sometimes is going to be helping you to indicate position or a place. Posición o un lugar. She was at her mother's house the night of the storm. En la casa de su madre, en la tormenta. École. ¿Sale? At the roundabout, take the third exit. En la rotonda, at the roundabout, take the third exit. En la rotonda. No es que estés ahí metido en la rotonda, estás en general. No en específico. Y sale. Mira, sometimes me voy a mover. Esta preposición va a ser una de las formitas que vamos a tener para indicar en dónde trabajamos o en dónde llevamos a cabo una actividad. She works at the new school. She studied at a foreign university. She's a lab researcher at Bayer. École. Sale. De Bayer, de la universidad, en una universidad extranjera. Una cosa es que te diga, she's in the university, ahí adentro, ahí metida, ahí ya. O en específico, otra, en la universidad, at the university. ¿En dónde estudias? En la preparatoria, at the high school. No te estoy diciendo in the high school, porque si te dijera, I am studying in the high school, significa que tú estás estudiando ahí metida ahorita, en un cuarto ahí de la preparatoria, ¿no? El in y el at te van a cambiar mucho dónde es que se o te encuentras, ¿no? Si dice, she's a lab researcher at Bayer, es una investigadora de laboratorio Bayer, en específico, pero no te, si yo te dijera, she's a lab researcher in Bayer, en Bayer significa que has de estar ahí metida dentro de ello, ¿no? Si te digo, she's at the house, ah, está en la casa. She's doing exercise in the house. Ella está haciendo ejercicio en la casa, significa que estoy haciendo ejercicio, pero aquí metida en la casa estoy brinca y brinca con mis pesas, etcétera. Ya dentro de una cuestión más de lugar con ciertas barreras, ¿no? Ay, no, te juro que quiero explicarte lo mejor posible todo esto porque son de las preposiciones donde más llegamos a tener confusión. No importa, de una vez te digo con todo cariño del mundo, aunque nos tardemos, pero en serio que quede bien, bien explicado. No se vale que, y no, nada, ahora le vaya el otro. No, 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 o sea, que quede, ¿sale? Porque son de las preposiciones que más vas a estar utilizando. Bueno, you can be using also at if you want to indicate that you are going to be in some group of activities. Para que indiques que vas a estar en algunas actividades grupales. There were thousands of people at the event. Miles de personas en el evento. No te estoy diciendo in the event, o sea, ahí metido. Es en cuestión así específica, no en lugar en específico. ¡Ay! En el concierto, en el esto, ¿dónde te golpeaste el ojo? ¡Ay! Oh, in the concert, ahí ya específicamente, ahí ya adentro, recluida, rodeada. Ahí es el in. Sale sobre todo en pocas palabras, ¿no? Was he at your party? Estuvo en tu en nuestra fiesta. Pero estuvo, he, si yo te dijera, was he in our party, estuvo en nuestra fiesta, o sea, estuvo ahí adentro, ahí tomando lugar, ahí adentro, bebiendo, comiendo, bailando, ahí adentro, 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 adentro. Mm. No, at, he was at your party, estuvo en tu fiesta, at your party, ¿no? Ahora, para dar direcciones, also, Sherlock Holmes lives at 221B Baker Street. Y para cuando estemos hablando de horas, de tiempo ya, her appointment is at 5. Para direcciones, para horas. Pero aquí todavía es de posición, prepositions of place, preposiciones de lugar. Y aquí ya está como de tiempo. Es para hablar del tiempo o del lugar. Bueno, hasta ahorita, y little by little, ¿no? Also, we are going to be having this. On. On is going to be for positions on as a profession. The on te va a indicar la posición, pero que está sobre algo, o sea, está encima, tocándolo. En, pero en encima. Put that on the floor, pon eso en el suelo, ahí sobre el suelo, que lo toque. The food is on the table, está en la mesa, pero en la mesa, ahí encima, tocándola, ahí sobrepuesta. ¿Sale? Ay, aquí se me juntó. Bueno, and for transport, she'll be on the bus by now. Autobús, acuérdate que es para vehículos largos, long vehicles, ¿ok? The signal is terrible on the train. La señal es terrible en el tren, casi una cobertura en el tren. En un vehículo largo. La elote es la más fácil, ¿ok? Y para ubicaciones es una zona que va a ser más grande. The cat must be somewhere in the living room. Cualquier lugar en el living room, ahí adentro, inmerso en cualquier lugar, in the house, ahí en la casa, dentro de la casa hay que buscarlo y tiene que estar. Or, for example, the castle is in Toledo. El castillo está en Toledo, ¿no? En Toledo, esa ciudad. Ahí dentro de esa ciudad, ahí está el castillo. Ahora, también vas a estar utilizando in, ya ves que ya te había dicho teacher in English, ya sé, but this is important. Cuando hay una cuestión reflexiva, informativa, en la lengua materna sirve mucho siempre que haya un aprendizaje, una reflexión, un conocimiento de la lengua extranjera. Por eso es que ahorita dije, bueno, todo el tiempo te hablé en inglés, ahorita por los nuevos y por la importancia del tema es que vamos ahí, ¿no? ¿Por qué estas tres? Bueno, no son tan difíciles, la verdad, solo distinguir el link con el hacha. Well, for places that we are going to be conceiving for, like a physical place and not as an institution. Aquí está lo que te decía. El lugar para lugares, pero si los vamos a concebir como un sitio meramente físico, la construcción y no como una institución. Por ejemplo, casa es algo físico, hogar es la institución, ¿no? Es algo más abstracto, por así decirlo. Dice, there are no patients in that hospital yet. Ahí, en ese edificio, no lo que representa ser un hospital, sino en ese edificio como tal. ¿Sale? The storm caused serious damage in the office. Causó grandes, graves daños en la oficina. En el lugar, pero físico, aquí una pared, un esto, no lo que representa, por ejemplo, el concepto de oficina. No sé si me va a entender. But we are going to be having some exceptions. She was in hospital for a week. Estuvo en el hospital por una semana. What is it going to be? What are we going to be having in there? Is the artificial. We are starting with this. ¿Ves? Se va poniendo bueno. Now, we are going to continue with this. Te toca. It's your turn. Can you fix the mistakes that we have in here? What could it be the mistakes that we are going to be having here? No soy tan mala. We are going to be having here the answers, but what are we going to do? Try to check the first of all this, and tomorrow we are going to be checking the answers, okay? First, try to do it by yourself and compare your answer with the other answers that I have in the next part, okay? What do you think? Easy or difficult? ¿Cómo lo vas viendo? ¿Fácil o difícil? Little by little, right? Poco a poquito. We are starting with this. Estamos empezando con esto. Nos falta un poquito. Sí, sí, sí. Pero va a valer la pena. Please, if you have questions or situations with this topic, let me know because I'm going to be helping you. Well, if you don't have any question, any situation, I'm going to say goodbye for today in order that you can be resting. But tomorrow we are going to continue with the second part of this. Okay, remember that if you have questions or situations, you can call me, you can send me a message, you need to let me know and promise that I'm going to be helping you. Te prometo que te ayudamos, no te me preocupes, pero comunícate con tu servidora. Luego dicen, ah, es muy fácil esto. Yes, in fact, indeed, it is super easy. But if I can help you in something, please be sure that that is going to be my pleasure, really. No me molesto, ni digo, ay, qué lata, ay, venlo en el video. No, para nada. Bueno, guapérrimos y guapérrimas, I have to say goodbye. Tomorrow we are going to continue with another video, but with more English. And any question, please let me know. Have a wonderful, wonderful day and night, and see you soon. Bye-bye.